Continues in a moment. 54. Bowen lobs to Dwayne Jones, right back to Justin. Bowen curls inside, sets up G, left baseline. He's guarded by Agunye, shoots over Yemi. Shot is blocked at the shot clock. And here come the Tulsa 66ers. Mustafa Shakur will be met three-quarter court by Gerald. Then dribbles through the lane, sets up Ihambe, another corner three around and out. Lands in the hands of Gerald. Long lead pass to Alonzo G. Stops, pops from 16, it's short. He did not have the numbers. And then Dwayne Jones had the rebound but threw it away. Now Tulsa's got numbers. Clark straight down the lane for the easy lay-in.
Yeah, this unfortunate play by the Toros resulted in the easy two. Resulting in the easy two for the 66ers. Almost another steal there by Mustafa Shakur. Curtis Gerald sets the offense.
Yeah, he'll back it out. Shot clock at 7 seconds. Gerald penetrates and draws the foul.
Toro's definitely fortunate to come away with two free throws here. Bowen had a dangerous cross-court pass that was almost stolen by Mustafa Shakur. Fortunately, Curtis Gerald was able to get the loose ball. As you see here, he's driving to the basket. Again, trying to finish with that right hand. Finds his way at the foul line.
Rebounding battle now 31-24 in favor of the Toros. So a 7-rebound margin.
What you want to see if you're a Toros fan. And it's been quite impressive, you know, tonight against the 66ers, who were already bigger than the Toros and got even bigger, even bigger than the Toros with Keith Clark coming back, another 6'8 athletic front court guy.
Yeah, he didn't play last night because of that bruised knee. Gerald's hit the freebie. He'll shoot one more on the way and good. So Curtis Gerald's has 13. Dwayne Jones also has 13 for the Toros. Clinch has 14. Foul on Curtis Gerald. Some full court pressure against Shakur. That's number 2 on Curtis Gerald. 3 players in double figures for the 66ers. Mullins with 10, 11 for Shakur, and 10 for Brown. Clark gets it across with some pressure from Justin Bowen. 64-56 Toros. Tulsa has the rock. Inside 5 minutes to play in the third, and we have a whistle and a traveling violation on Keith Clark.
Yeah, you can see that coming. Keith Clark did a nice job coming back, helping with the pressure Curtis Gerald was putting on Mustafa Shakur, and got the ball over half court, but he should have gave it back to him and let Shakur initiate the offense. Instead, he tried to make a move to the basket, got called for the travel.
And I think they just called a touch foul on Gerald trying to brush Shakur's hands off him. Gerald was just dribbling the basketball. Shakur playing tight defense, and Gerald slapped at his hands as if to say, get off me.
Yeah, that stuff's been going on all night. I don't know why. You know, that's one of the problems players have with referees. You know, you let the game go for a half or, you know, all over a half, being called one way, and then when they do the same things, they change up on it and, you know, call it a foul.
Cecil Brown back out there for Tulsa. Bounce pass to Mullins. Up top, Agunye. Nice ball rotation. Here's a three-pointer. That is good from Mustafa Shakur, demonstrating that he can shoot it from long range, his second three of the game.
Yeah, I'm a believer in his shot, but that play was set up by Byron Mullins, getting his 7-foot frame down on the post, like we've been saying, creating a double team, and the 66ers finding the open man, Shakur, for the three-point shot.
Alonzo G, hesitation dribble. Nice pass cross-court to Clinch. Head fake, cut off, then forces one up and connects right over Cecil Brown.
That was great defense by Cecil Brown, but better offense by Lewis Clinch.
Shakur races down the floor, sets up Brown for three, no good at Karam's left, and Clinch has the rebound. Gives to Gerald. Gerald hits the break, shoots from 19, in and out, and the rebound saved by Cecil Brown. And up the floor come the 66ers, down by 7, dribbling through the lane of Shakur. Russell Carter about to check in. Next dead ball for the Toros. Shakur spinning, fading, shooting from 14, and gets the friendly roll.
Great move by Mustafa Shakur, getting in the lane on the spin and the finish, but it's definitely something going on between Curtis Gerald and Mustafa Shakur. Those two are definitely going at each other. Going to make for a good basketball the rest of the way.
Dwayne Jones back to the basket against Mullen. Spins baseline, draws the foul. It's going to be on the floor. This officiating crew of Don Hudson, Ben Taylor, Scott Twardarski, they've been busy tonight.
Yeah, very busy. It's been a great ball game. You know, a lot of action up and down going both ways. Mullins really got to be careful here. He already has one technical. He's arguing his fifth foul. Don't want to get that second one, big fella. You're having a good game so far.
He'll come out, replaced by Harden. G, also to the bench for the Toros. So the lineup out there for the Austin Toros has Dwayne Jones, who's at the free throw line and just connected.
Mm-hmm.
Lewis Clinch, Curtis Gerald, Russell Carter, and David McClure. Kind of a shorter lineup. Jones with another free throw. That's good.
Outside of Jones, I don't know many other tall players on their team. I think the Toros are going to have a lot of short lineups.
That's a good point. Shakur, pull up, 10-footer, good off the glass. Bank open late night here in Austin.
Definitely. Curtis Gerald, I think, with that offensive foul, slapping his hand away, might have ignited something in Shakur because he's been attacking ever since then.
What was once an 11-point lead for the Toros is down to 5 with 2.5 left to play in the third. Lewis Clinch, left wing, drive, stop, shoots over his defender, Cecil Brown, and hits again.
Almost the identical shot from the identical spot. I mean, the same spot on the floor, and a little pump fake fadeaway from Lewis Clinch on, 16 feet on the baseline.
Keith Clark guarded by McClure. A couple of ACC players going at it. And here's a shot from Brown that's no good. And then Gerald loses it, picks it back up. Gerald at the three-point line. Gerald gets a high screen from Dwayne Jones, hits the brakes, cross court to the cutter. Carter down the lane, flips to McClure, 15-footer is no good. And the rebound taken by Harden, who was able to leap above everybody. Shakur in transition, pulls up, top of the key jumper is perfect.
Has a little bit of something to say going back to Curtis Gerald. He's definitely feeling it right now, playing both ends of the floor, being scrappy on defense. Shooting getting to the rack on offense and shooting jumpers. Curtis Gerald's definitely going to have to step it up.
He's got 20 points, Shakur. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Clinch is tripped by Shakur, and they're going to get a foul on Mustafa. Minute 18 left to play in the third, 70-65. Toros by 5, but Tulsa's not going away.
No, Tulsa's not going away. They're playing really hard, but hats off to the Toros. They're weathering this storm. They've lost a little bit on their lead. But the type of ferocity the 66ers are showing, they're very fortunate to still be up 5 points, possibly 7, as Clinch goes to the free throw line.
Lewis Clinch has not attempted a lot of free throws this season, but he is a very good foul shooter until now. Right off the back of the rim, huh?
Yeah, at least we're consistent with our jinxes.
Yeah. Clinch shoots another one, and it's good. You would think that if you and I were doing games in the NBA, then we would have less ability to jinx the guys because they would be better free throw shooters, right?
I would hope so, because I think we're both going to be there one day.
Clinch has 17 as he splits the pair. 71-65, Cecil Brown in the lane, a little bit out of control, but somehow gets it to go with the left hand against McClure.
It's a great move by Cecil Brown. Hadn't been able to knock down a shot his last two or three attempts. Decides to take it to the basket against the tough defense of David McClure with the left-handed finish.
Carl Dell Squeaky Johnson tries to penetrate, cut off by Mitch Johnson. Seems like those two are always matched up against each other. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Carter spinning in the lane. Fade shoots from 10. No good. Dwayne Jones the rebound. Lost it. Yemi Agunye scoops it up for Tulsa. And they're down by just 4 points with 30 seconds left in the third quarter.
Great fight. Great fight. It'll keep you in any type of ball game, especially if you're not making shots.
Cecil Brown veers to the left wing, flips it up top to Clark. Great extra pass to Harden, shot no good, and a whistle and a foul on the Toros. It's on Squeaky Johnson.
Great extra pass by Keith Clark. Thought he was open for the top of the key jump shot. He looked in, saw his man Devon Harden ducking in, as you see here, and he had the great, footwork. Great footwork down there to get a shot off.
Free throw is good for Harden. Harden, his first point in the third quarter. He's got 5 for the game. Second free throw is good.
First and second points of the third quarter after a few missed dunks. Those things would have been very nice had he had them to go down, though.
It's a 2-point game. Toros will get the last shot here in the third. Clock shows 7 seconds. Shot clock turned off. Squeaky Johnson down the lane. Throws the alley-oop for Dwayne. Dwayne couldn't get it to go. Tips it over to Squeaky, and his foot was on the end line. Squeaky threw the alley-oop, but Dwayne did not go up and get it.
Yeah, it's a good play by Squeaky Johnson, but Dwayne Jones just wasn't ready for it.
Midcourt shot, the end of the third for Cecil. It's no good. And after three, the Tulsa 66ers climb back to within two. The lead was 5 at the break. Now it's only 2. 71-69 after three. Toros in front. Back for the fourth quarter when